today I'm going to show you how to create a new project on Cryengine. First you have to get the Cryengine launcher as I did, and then you're gonna add a new project. Then it's gonna show you some templates. If you want a VR one or a blank one, you can add more project types from their website. So let's just get started. Here you can see that you have to name your project. I'm just gonna say my game, and then you're just gonna create your project. Now it's gonna launch, so we just have to wait for. Okay, now our project has launched, but as you can see that everything is so blank. So what we're gonna do is create a new level. Just right click on the asset browser. It will show you some options. Select level and then name your level. I'm just gonna name it my level. So now you can see that it's gonna show you some dimensions, that are height and width of the map. I'm just gonna choose the smallest one. Let's go for 1024, just to show you. Okay, now it's gonna give you a terrain. See, so it's just a basic terrain. You can edit it to create new objects and stuff. Okay, to zoom in on the camera and zoom out on the camera, you can adjust your speed from over here. Okay, and you can control your camera from WASD buttons, and also from your mouse. Just right click on your mouse and move up and down using the WASD buttons. Okay, and after that, I'm just gonna show you the basic tools to use Cryengine. First of all, we just need to turn this frame rate off. You can turn the frame rate off from the display side. Here you can see that there's a menu bar. Just click on that cycle display info. It will eventually go away. Okay, so now I'm just gonna show you the tools, how to use the tools. First of all, I'm gonna just show you. As you can see on your right corner, there should be a menu about terrain editor and a properties menu. So select terrain editor, and here you can see that you have three options: sculpt, paint, or minimap. So using the sculpt option, you can edit your terrain and resize or make it look differently. So I'm just gonna show you how to change the radius. As you can see that the radius of the area I'm covering is really small, so you can change that from over here. Under the brush area, you can see outside radius, inside radius, hardness and height. So if you want to change the height, that how high the mountains or whatever your building is gonna be, so it will go that high to that height, and it can show how the hardness. You can also change the hardness, and you can also change the inside radius and the outside radius. Okay, so here you can see that the size of my brush has changed. See? Okay, so from here you can change the outside radius of your brush size and inside radius. So let me just show you here. Okay, the radius has changed, and you can see that I've built a small spot there. Okay, now I'm also gonna tell you that how to undo what you have done. So go to the edit option here and click on undo, and as you can see that it will disappear. After that, you can also smoothen the edges, like, okay, and you can also raise or lower the area like this. I'm just gonna change the height just to show you how it works. Do you see that the area is starting to raise up? Now do you see that it's a rigid body and you can see the lines on it. So you can edit it and smoothen it down. So you can just select the smooth and then just start clicking on the area. It will smoothen it for you. And if you want to move this thing, you just have to select the move area. Now I'm going to tell you how to paint your terrain. First of all, you're going to select default colors. You can also add the paint colors, or you can also create them. Okay. From here, you can see you can generate terrains and generate terrain textures and all that. So you can add custom paints as well. So this is just a startup, so I'm just going to show you how to add a default color. So just change the color from here. Do you see this? Okay. You're just going to change it from filter color and choose the color that you want on it. And then just click where you want to color. Okay, after selecting the color, you're just gonna go toward the brush option. It will be on the lower right corner. Just select the brush button and then change the range. Okay, the range will show you where how much you can color. And then just start clicking on the area that you want to color, like this. The color will start to appear. It will slow your computer a bit, but when you're done, it's gonna be okay. See? So after this, I'm just gonna introduce you to a little options. First, you're gonna have to do is you have to save your work, because if you don't, it's eventually not gonna save. So you have to enable the autosave option, or you have to save it from here. Okay. And after that, I'm gonna show you how to change the layers. As you can see on the right upper area, there's an animation layout, cinematic layout, level design layout, and flow graph layout. From level design layout, you can add objects in your area or your terrain from here. And this is almost about it for the start. Thank you for watching.